today we are going to see new columns and new measure. Okay, so in the previous class till now we have completed, we have seen the introduction of Power BI and what are the syllabus I am going to cover in this Power BI training, and then we have seen types of filters for developer. Okay, types of filters can be implemented in the reports. Okay, so today we are going to see new columns and new measure. Okay, calculated columns and new measure. Okay, what are those? So let me double click on Power BI desktop. Let me open it. Okay, so we are going to create few new columns, calculated columns, okay, out of the existing data set, and we are going to see new measures and what is the difference between new calculated columns and new measure. Okay, I will go to get data, and then I will click on Excel. Okay, so let's do not take the input. Let me take one thing. If I want to create a table with the help of Power BI, okay, I don't want to import any data set. I want to create it through Power BI only, inside Power BI only. What should I do? I will click, go to enter data. Okay, let me open that presentation pan. Okay, where I will go to? I will go to enter data. Okay, so guys, let me put it here. Okay, so we are going to go to enter data. Okay, from here we can create a manual table by ourselves. We can create table and we can feed the data as well. Okay, and we can use it as a data set in Power BI. Okay, so let me click on enter data. It will pop up a window. Where it will ask you for the table name. Let me take the sales data. Okay, sales data. Okay, first column, let me make it as get category. Category actual cost sales cost. Okay, category will be, let me make it in capital letters, sales data. Category name, or let me take product name, actual cost sales cost. Okay, product name. Okay, actual cost. Okay, sales cost. Okay, so let me take, for example, product A, B, B, C. Okay, and then actual cost may be, let's assume 300 300 300, 400 400 500. Okay, and what can be the sales cost? Let's take it 450 450 450, 600 600, 750. ओके, क्लिक ऑन लोअर। Okay, so I have taken this data, okay, and it created here, it got here, okay. Let me go to the data tab to see it, okay. Let me go to data tab, okay. So guys, for example, if I want to know the count of the product name, what should I do, okay? What should I do, okay? I can create a new column here, okay, which will get added here, okay, and here you can see the values populated by our logic implementation, okay. By using DEX functionality, we can write an expressions here and we can create a new column, okay. So there are two ways to create a new column. Either we can create a new column from here by clicking on here, okay, or either we can create, right click on this, and we can create it from here, okay. So let me show you that. Right click on this and click on new column, okay. Anything you can do, okay. I have clicked on this and created a new column, and let me name it as C underscore product UUNT count, okay, product count, okay. So what I will do, I need to find a count of it, so I can take here count. So this count gives us counts the number in the column, okay, counts the numbers in the column. Second count is counts the number of values in the column, okay. So let's take a count A, okay, count A, and what is the column name? Column name is product name. Let me take product name and enter, okay. So guys, it gave me six count, okay, it gave me six count. Let me go back to the visualization tab and let me create a bar chart here. As you can see, the column got created here with populated values, got populated, and it got added here as well, okay. So this is the sign of new calculated column, new column, okay, okay. So let me go back there and let me take product count with product name. So let me take table and let me take product count, okay. So guys, it is giving 18, 12 and 6, okay. So this is not showing the right figure, as you can see. Column is not showing the right figure in this way, okay. Let me increase the font size here. Okay. And let me take a bar chart also. And product name with product. Let me populate the data label. Okay. And let me increase the data label size and the x-axis data size, okay. Now 6, 12 and 18, it calculated the count in it. Okay, it calculated the count of it. Now let me create a measure here. Okay, I will click on new measure. Okay, and I will name it as m underscore product underscore count. Okay, I will take here count a and product name, enter. Okay, so you can see measure did not took any space here. Okay, as well as it added here as well. Okay, it got added here, but it did not specify the values here. That means it do not take some memory. Okay, before going to measure, I want to tell you the difference between measure, new measure, and calculated column. Let me take a notepad. Okay, and let me tell you new column versus new measure. Okay, new measure. Okay, now new column. New, what is new column? New column can be defined as derived column, which gets derived from existing column. Okay, in this we can derive from existing column by doing all the calculations, by manipulating the data, by defining our logic. We extract the some data and we define the logic, we manipulate the data according to the expression we give there, and we derive a new column. Okay, and the values in this column are static. That means, okay, the values in the new columns are static. Okay, this occupies a memory. New column, it occupies memory. Okay, it occupies memory. That means, as you can see in Power BI, it got created here. Okay, and you can see all the values into this. Okay, that means it occupies memory. Okay, let me close it, let me go back here. Okay, but in terms of new measure, okay, what it do in terms of new measure, actually it do not occupy the memory. Okay, it is a expression. These are an expression. Okay, stored in model. Okay, this is an expression stored in model. Okay, it will not occupy any memory. Okay, it is dynamic. Okay, it is dynamic. Okay, it is dynamic. Okay, it will, so as it is dynamic, it gets populated whenever you show the visualization, whenever you run the report. That means it will impact the performance if there is a large volume data. So it will affect, it will impact the performance. Getting the point, guys? Okay, let's go back to our report and we will see how measure is working. Okay, so I will click on measure, it got created here. Let me go back to the report and let me take a table here and let me put product name with measure. Okay, so you can see the difference here is, I will increase the width grid text. You can see now I will take one more visualization as the bar chart, and here I will take product name with measure. Okay, let me go here and I will take data labels and I will go to X axis, increase the font size, and I will go to data labels and increase the font size. So guys, you can see here there is a huge difference between both new column and new measure. Whenever I said I want to count the product, that means I am counting the number of products. So A is coming three times there. Okay, so it is counting the recursion of A into the table which I have created. B came two times. Okay, C came one time. Okay, so this is what measure is representing here. Okay, but in column it is multiplying it by, so when I will say count, count is 6, total count is 6, so 6 into 3 is 18. So this is some irrelevant logic which should not be implemented in this condition. Okay, new columns are very important to derive a new column, but whenever you are using function inside a function, you should not use new column, you should use new measure in that case. Okay, so I hope you got the difference. Let me take one more example. Okay, I will go back to the data tab, and you have not seen the benefits of new column. Okay, so let me create new column, one more new column. For example, I want to retrieve the profit out of here. So what should I do? I will define here profit C_profit. Okay, and how the profit will come? Sales cost minus actual cost. Okay, sales cost minus actual cost, enter. Okay, sales cost minus actual cost. Okay, now if I do a visualization here, I will take a new page and I will take visualization here. I will take product name with C profit, column profit. Okay, so it is summing up the profit here. Let me see the x-axis and let me go to data labels and increase the text size. Okay, so you can see 450, 400 and 250. How it is coming? It is summing up the values for A 450, for B it is 400, for C it is 250. Getting the point? Okay, now if I want to retrieve percentage, profit percentage, what should I do? I will go to new column again. I will add one more new column here and I will name it as C_profit%. Okay, C_profit%. Okay, how we are going to retrieve the profit percent? Profit divided by actual cost, bracket close, from here bracket open, multiplied by 100, enter. C_profit%. The syntax star multiplied by 100. So let me take one more thing. Let me take one more column here. Let me open it from here. Close it from here. Let me move it. Here. Okay. Now it should work fine. Okay. So 50, 50, 50, and every product have got 50% profit. Okay. Let's go back here. Okay. And let me take profit percentage here. So let me delete this and let me convert it to from profit to profit percentage. Okay, so this is 150, 100, and 50. Again, there is some issue with here. It is summing up the profit. Okay, percentage. It is summing up the percentage, which is not correct. Okay, if you can see, 150 is coming from A, 100 is coming from B, and 50 is coming from C. Okay, it is summing up the profit percentage. I don't want to do that. It is not right. I need a common profit percentage for every product. So what should I do? In that case, I will create a new measure. Okay. And click on new measure. And I will take here M underscore profit percent. Okay, and underscore profit percent. Here, what I will do, I will take one sum of profit divided by again sum of actual cost, bracket close, and then again one more bracket star 100 into 100. Okay, got the point, guys? Enter. So it got created here, and now let's go to the visualization tab and draw this visualization for measure. Okay, let me take this one and let me take M underscore profit and product name. So you can see, let me take data labels, enable the data labels, increase the text size, go back to the x-axis, increase the size. Okay, so this is now showing the correct percentage profit into all three. Okay, that is 50, 50, 50. This is measure, this is column, new column. Got the point, guys? What's the difference? Okay, so this is calculated columns and new measure. I hope you got the concept of new columns and new measures. We are going to do multiple examples on this on daily basis, and you will come to know after 2-3 classes perfectly what is the difference between both of them. Okay, thanks for.